want to give you a brief overview of the corpuls CPR. We'll start with the different contents in the bags and then move on to the operating controls that we find on the device itself. Then we'll move on to the energy management and finish with the different boards. Here we have the corpuls CPR with the rec board in the appropriate bag for it. You can find the board on the top and everything else you need is in a compartment. As you can see, the arm is already pre-fitted with the short stamp. Directly underneath is a bag with the long stamp and one replacement stamp in each size. The second bag holds a charged spare battery. And the third bag holds the various power cords. But we'll talk about that in more detail in energy management. On the top, we find another compartment that houses the fixation ring, which is required for the rec board and the scoop board. We also have the pocket card, outlining the four-step approach in here.
In contrast to the contents of the bag, which is variable, the corpuls CPR operating controls are always the same. First of all, the bayonet lock to connect the arm to the board. It clicks into place when I place it directly on the board. To loosen it, turn it once and lift it upwards. To avoid tilting, always make sure that it is placed vertically. The second operating control is the locking lever. To open it, it is advised to place one hand on the front of the device and then pull it back firmly. The various joints can only be moved when the locking lever is fully open. Especially when adjusting the height, make sure to hold the corpuls CPR at the back to avoid tilting. As soon as the locking lever is closed, all the joints tighten again. Closing the locking lever should be done with the palm of your hand, with a slapping motion to prevent your hand from getting caught. Open, close. The corpuls CPR can be switched on under the arm. I start the therapy by pressing this button on top here. And to end the therapy, I press it again. Various soft keys are arranged next to the display. By simultaneously pressing two soft keys, on one side you can change the screen direction, which improves readability on the other side. If I press the buttons on the left side, at the same time, the display inverts, and I can read it better under adverse lighting conditions. We show the therapy options that can be changed using the soft keys in a separate tutorial.
The remaining battery life can also be seen on the display. This is recognizable by the small battery symbol next to it. Ideally, this is 90 minutes. If during the mission I think, oh, it's getting a bit tight, there are two options. Option one is to connect the corpuls CPR directly to an external power supply, either directly to the vehicle power supply or to a wall socket. If neither of these options are available, you can obviously also change the battery. If I decide to change the battery during ongoing therapy, I should have the spare battery ready beforehand. I can simply pause the therapy, remove the battery by pressing the two red buttons, insert the new battery. The device then automatically starts up again and I can immediately continue the therapy. I have 30 seconds to do this, but if I have the battery ready beforehand, that's more than enough time. The corpuls CPR can also be charged inside the bag. To do so, open the flap with the Velcro fastener and attach the magnetic connector. You can then assess the charge status of the battery through the viewing window at the top.
There are three boards available on the market for the corpuls CPR. All three are completely radiolucent. I will show you the quad board first. The quad board is intended more for in-hospital use, and it can be easily pushed under the patient. However, it is not possible to fix the patient, say for example, during transport. Also, with the rec board, the arm position on the patient can be freely selected. I have the fixation options here too. In combination with the fixation ring, And as a further tool for pre-hospital use, the scoop board can ideally be positioned in scoop stretchers or modern stretcher pads. The patient can also be secured here with the fixation ring and the fixation options during transport. The patient lies slightly lower on the scoop board. Therefore, the height difference must be compensated for with the stamp extension. Here, the arm position is not freely selectable, and the stamp extension is only used with the scoop board. The stamp extension for the scoop board can be easily inserted, connected, and then pressed into the arm. The scoop board comes with its own backpack. In this tutorial, we were able to show you the individual system components of the corpuls CPR. We took a look at the backpacks and bags. We talked about energy management and the operating controls. And I was able to briefly show you the boards.
What we have just learned about the boards is that there are different options. You should definitely familiarize yourself with what you have on site, what accessories you have on site, and get yourself acquainted with them. So that you don't miss anything and to see the device in action, please subscribe to our channel and check out our other videos.